Good evening and welcome to the first and only vice presidential debate of 2012. I am Martha Raddatz of ABC News, and I'm honored to be here moderating tonight's debate. We have a wonderful audience, and it should be a lively evening. Right now, we welcome Vice President Joe Biden and Congressman Paul Ryan. Welcome, gentlemen. And before we begin, a reminder that your performance tonight is extremely unlikely to affect the outcome of the election, so just have fun with it.
Oh, you bet, you bet. Okay.
Congressman Ryan, we begin with your opening statement.
Thank you. First of all, I want to thank Senator College for hosting us this evening.
Oh, boy, here we go. Oh, man.
4 years ago, President Obama made a promise. That he would bring down unemployment below 6%.
Oh, this guy. I mean...
He said, but by the end of his first term, he would cut the deficit in half.
Oh!
And yet he still has not put a single credible plan on the table on how to deal with the debt crisis.
Okay, I'm sorry, Martha. I'm Martha, but with all due respect, this is a bunch of malarkey, all right? This is malarkey.
A bunch of malarkey?
Yeah.
What does that mean?
It's Irish.
No. Irish is, I come over there and smack that dumb look off your face.
Hey!
That's Irish.
Hey! Do I sound like Jim Lehrer?
No.
No.
And do I look like Jim Lehrer?
No, you
no.
don't.
Then don't try and me like I'm Jim Lehrer. Are we clear?
Absolutely.
Yeah, absolutely. We got it.
Good. The number one issue here at home is jobs. My question to both of you is, can you get unemployment to under 6%, and how long will it take?
Martha, Vice President Biden and I come from very similar places. I'm from Janesville, Wisconsin, and he's from Scranton, Pennsylvania. Do you know what the unemployment rate in Scranton is right now?
I sure do.
It's 10%. Mm-hmm. And I just wonder what the Vice President would say to the hardworking people of towns like Janesville and Scranton.
Well, I know what I'd say to my friend and the people of Janesville. Things may be bad where you live, but I guarantee you, it is a paradise next to the burning coal heap that is Scranton, Pennsylvania. I mean, do you know that show, Walking Dead, The Walking Dead? It would make a good tourism ad for Scranton. I mean, if you went to the lowest circle of hell, you'd still be 45 minutes outside of Scranton. I grew up there. I love it. It's the single worst place on earth.
It seems many Americans are disenchanted with the political process and two parties who just can't seem to work together. Is the era of bipartisanship over?
Well, I would agree that the president and the vice president haven't done the work to reach across the aisle, but I personally put together a bipartisan Medicare plan.
Yeah, there's not one Democrat who endorses it.
One partner is a Democrat from Oregon.
No, he no longer supports it.
A former Clinton budget director.
Who disavows it?
A Democratic congressman said he liked it.
Yeah, he's missing. He's presumed dead. So, is that. Look,
Mr. Vice President, I know you're under a lot of duress to make up for lost ground, but I think the people would be better served if we didn't keep interrupting each
Ooh,
other.
You don't scare me, shark eyes. All right?
Mr. Vice President.
Hey, look, you think you're tougher than me because you do the P90X workout, huh? Because you're younger than me? Well, let me tell you something, buddy. There's Jim Strong and there's Old Man Strong, okay? You want to know my workout? When the Amtrak breaks down on my morning commute, I strip down to my tidy whities. I push that bitch all the way to Washington. That's right. Truth. I tell you what, man, I am monkey strong, brother.
Congressman. The Romney-Ryan team has been criticized for not giving specifics on their economic plan. How do you respond to these charges?
Our economic plan is simple. We are going to close loopholes, bring down tax rates, and erase the deficit.
Can you please be more specific?
No. But let me say it again with hand gestures. When it comes to the loopholes, we are going to close them. When it comes to tax rates, we are going to bring them down. And when it comes to the deficit, we are going to erase it.
Congressman Ryan, I've just been told America's small children would like you to stop looking directly into the lens. apparently, they find it upsetting.
Oh, understood.
Okay. Moving on, the baseball playoffs are in full swing with four teams remaining, the Yankees, Tigers, Giants, and Cardinals. So if you can, could you please speak personally about abortion?
About 10 years ago, my wife Jana and I went to Mercy Hospital in Janesville for our 7th week ultrasound of our firstborn child. And we saw a little baby that was in the shape of a bean. And to this day, we have nicknamed our firstborn child Bean. We also nicknamed our second and third child Bean. I figured out later, that's what all babies look like at 7 weeks. They look like beans. And the only thing I love more than beans is babies.
Ooh. Vice President Biden.
Look, Martha, I'm a Catholic. I'm a real world Catholic. Now, when it comes to church, I may not go every Sunday, but on Christmas Eve, I am front row center, singing Joy to the World as loudly and as off-key as I can. I accept the teachings of the Catholic Church, but then, like most Catholics, I ignore them and do what I want, all right? Now, I feel kind of guilty about that, but, yeah, whatever.
Closing statements, Joe Biden.
To our seniors, I want to say, folks, who do you trust on this? All right, to our troops, I want to say, guys and gals, we honor your service. To the Afghan troops, who will soon take over the security of their own nation, I say, Akala Makal Ura. And to the young people out there who are worried they're never gonna see that Social Security they're entitled to, I say, don't worry, homies. Big Daddy Joe's got your back. Peace out.
And Congressman Ryan.
Don't let anyone tell you something's impossible. Take it from me. Not only have I run a sub-3-hour marathon and a sub-4-minute mile, just this summer, with very little training, I competed in and won the 100 meters at the London Olympics.
Oh, that's not true.
Yes, it is true.
No, it's not.
If you don't believe me, ask my running partner, Usain Bolt.
Oh, okay.
Usain? Usain, please tell him who won the 100 meters.
I did.
You did. And where did I finish?
You didn't finish. You weren't even there.
Thank you, Usain.
No problem.
That concludes tonight's debate.
I'm sorry, Martha. Martha, can I just do one last thing?
Sure.
Please? Okay. There we go. Oh, things have been driving me crazy, huh?
And live from New York.